Israeli firm unveils armed robot to patrol volatile borders. Load, on Monday, an Israeli defense contractor presented a remote-controlled armed robot that can patrol conflict zones, locate infiltrators, and open fire, according to the company. The unmanned vehicle is the most recent advancement in the realm of drone technology, which is fast changing the modern battlefield. Proponents argue that semi-autonomous machines allow armies to better defend their troops, while detractors worry that this is yet another perilous step toward robots making life or death decisions. The REX MKII, a four-wheel drive robot created by Israel Aerospace Industries, was unveiled on Monday. It's controlled by an electronic tablet and can be outfitted with two machine guns, cameras, and sensors, Rani Avni, the company's deputy head of Autonomous Systems Division, explained. The robot can gather intelligence for ground troops, transport injured soldiers and supplies into and out of battle, and strike targets nearby. It is the most advanced of more than a half dozen unmanned vehicles produced by ELTA Systems, a subsidiary of the aerospace industry, during the last 15 years. The Israeli military is currently using the Jaguar, a smaller but similar vehicle, to patrol the Gaza Strip's border and help enforce a blockade imposed by Israel in 2007, after the tiny territory was seized by the militant group Hamas. Gaza is home to 2 million Palestinians who have been essentially trapped by the embargo, which is backed in part by Egypt. Protests are common along the border, as are occasional attempts by Palestinian militants or desperate laborers to infiltrate Israel. When asked for details on how the Israeli army uses the Jaguar, one of numerous instruments, including drones armed with guided missiles, that have given it immense technological superiority over Hamas, the Israeli army did not react. Other armies, like those of the United States, the United Kingdom, and Russia, are progressively employing unmanned ground vehicles. Their responsibilities include logistical assistance, mine disposal, and weapon firing. The tablet can control the vehicle manually. Many of its operations, such as its movement and surveillance systems, can, however, run independently. The device captures additional data with each mission, which it then uses to train for future missions, said Yanni Gij, an operational expert in the company's robotics division. Critics have expressed fears that robotic weapons could decide to shoot targets on their own, possibly erroneously. According to the corporation, such capabilities exist, but are not available to customers. It is possible to make the weapon itself autonomous, however, this is currently a user decision, Avni said. The maturity of the system or the user is not there yet. Bonnie Doherty, a senior researcher with Human Rights Watch's arms section, said such weapons are concerning because they can't be trusted to distinguish between fighters and civilians, or to make appropriate decisions about the harm assaults may bring to nearby populations. Machines cannot understand the value of human life, which in essence undermines human dignity and violates human rights laws, Doherty said. Doherty, a Harvard Law School lecturer, proposed for fully automated weapons to be outlawed under international law in a 2012 report. The development of autonomous ground vehicles has lagged behind that of autonomous aircraft and boats, according to the defense journal Jane's, because traveling through land is significantly more difficult than traversing water or air. Unlike the open ocean, vehicles have to deal with holes in the road and know exactly how much force to apply to overcome a physical obstacle, the report said. Concerns have also been expressed about self-driving vehicle technology. Tesla, among other firms, has been linked to a number of tragic accidents, including one in Arizona in 2018 in which a lady was struck by a car that was on autopilot. At this week's Defense and Security System International Armaments Trade Expo in London, the Israeli drone vehicle is on display.